Now, I know it's a Wednesday, but we like sometimes to start our weekend early. And the best we could do is to bring you this amazing guest. I'm going to try and get through all his titles as fast as I can. TV and radio host and entrepreneur. He is a MC. He is a hype man. He's a businessman. And he has got so many amazing initiatives for the youth. And he's here to tell us all about it. Please welcome to the show, DNG.
Thank you so much for having
one
me.
One and only.
I'm excited to be here. Thank
That's
you.
A rap sheet. I mean, how many? Yeah, like how?
That's
five,
a CV
six,
and
seven?
A half.
Thank you. Thank you, man. I think you got to work hard and you got to, you know, put out there everything that you want to achieve. I don't think you should ever hold back. So if you want to do multiple things at the same time, go for it.
I know. Don't limit yourself, especially in entertainment. I feel like people are bossed.
Everybody does everything.
Like if you do this, like you, people think you've got to do this. You also did music as well. By the way, I didn't say that, musician.
Yeah, I started with music back in the day, and since 2003. I stopped doing music maybe around 2012, thereabout. Then I've done radio, I've done obviously MCing, television. Acting as well.
Yes, you were.
I was on a show, a Swahili show. I don't remember. Sumula Penze. And I was this cool radio DJ, you know, ladies man, on the show.
On the show.
And apart from that, I run an agency that does events and experiential marketing and brand activations for different corporate brands. It's called 254 Entertainment. And you know, we employ hundreds of young people across the country. So we are creating employment as well. Apart from that, I'm big on social impact. So I'm on my second initiative right now called Punguza, but I started one other one in 2017 called Hustle Yako. That's on youth empowerment and development with a specific focus on career, business and entrepreneurship. And now we're talking about responsible sexual behavior. So our focus is youth, and our focus is you know, steering young people towards the right direction and giving back. Wow. That's our form.
It's always and you have 24 hours in a day.
Right? Yeah.
It's always so challenging to interview a presenter because you guys immediately answer all of sort of the surface questions. Like, what are you about? Where did you come from? All of these things. But you've mentioned your current initiative, and the question that came to my mind when I read about it is, what is going to make Punguza different from any other initiative or NGO that already exists?
I think first and foremost, it's by young people for young people. Other initiatives, you know, are conceptualized in boardrooms by directors and managers who don't even interact with young people. I engage young people online, on ground, on a daily basis. So I know exactly what young people are going through. I'm young myself. The team behind the conceptualizing is youthful. Believe it or not, we've had even write shops with where we've involved teenagers. Like, we have to get parental consent, and they come and they sit for 2-3 days and contribute to the ideation and conceptualization of our initiative. So that's the difference, that young people are involved from beginning to the execution. Apart from that is that, for us, we're not trying to tell people, you know, what not to do or what to do. We want to give people information and encourage them to make informed choices. Also, you know, every other initiative from the church, from, you know, the corporate players have always been talking about abstinence.
An abstinence-only program tends to be the choice
and,
from a church.
And if we were to do a survey here, how many people have abstained?
Whoop.
You know what I'm saying? So abstinence isn't practical because the teenagers we're talking about, the youth we're talking about, are sexually active. So how do you teach abstinence or propagate abstinence towards an already sexually active generation?
How do you have it with integrity when it's not happening?
It's true. So I have two questions for you. May I ask on air, how old are you?
I'm 33.
You're 33.
33 years young.
I should have asked, how old do I look?
I know. You're 25.
Baby face.
Okay, so the youth, what inspired you to work with the youth?
Believe it or not, I've worked with young people since the beginning. I started off as a gospel artist, so we used to do ministry.
Why is everyone, wow.
I don't know, I think
never
it's just...
Everybody starts in the church.
Yeah, and funny enough, in the church, they're very elaborate programs that develop talent and gifts, from dancing to acting to skits, poetry, name it. So I started off as a gospel musician, so we used to do ministry in high schools, campuses, we've gone to prisons, estates, door to door, and that has never really left. Even if I don't do music anymore, I feel like the calling towards young people is my purpose. So right now, this is a legacy program for me, for my organization.
Yeah.
And young people are the heart of the work we do. Mm-hmm. Young people are my core consumer base. Mm-hmm. Even though I do corporate events where I'm launching, you know, brands.
They are the future.
The events that you know, where we engage youth, for me are everything. Yeah. Right now I feel like I'm in my core purpose and it's beautiful. So that's why I want to give back, and I want to give my time to young people to teach.
It's true.
To guide, to mentor.
You know, usually when somebody's this, like, you know, purposeful about the youth, maybe they had the same when they were coming up. Mm-hmm. When you were coming up, do you have anyone or a particular group or people who did the same thing you're doing for other people? Like, you know, held your hand or, you know, kind of brought you up, took the elevator down?
Very interestingly, when I was doing gospel music from the scratch, I joined an organization called Kubamba. You might know about Kubamba Crew. So, you know, they everything I learned as an entertainer, as a performer, getting the courage to get on stage, talk to people, hype up the crowd, I learned from them. So I believe that was my, I don't know how to put it, my developing ground. And you know, without them, I don't think I would have had an opportunity to grow my talent as I did. So it's my turn now to give back. You know, a lot of people think that giving back is all about dishing out money. But it's not about that. I think if I teach you how to fish rather than give you fish to eat, I will have impacted you for a lifetime rather than for 24 hours. So that's what I'm doing.
So, like, what is one of the greatest lessons that you've learned so far working with the youth? Not one of the youth that's learned from you. What is the greatest lesson that you've learned?
Wow, I think young people teach me so many things. I think one thing is that we need to listen. A lot of organizations, you're saying, have done initiatives where they talk at youth. They tell you, do not, like parents will tell you, don't, girls are bad or boys are bad. If you hang around boys, you get pregnant, and you don't go to school, and you become a loser. And if you do that, you go back to Shago.
You get pregnant, you die.
And they don't take time to understand what are these young people going through. When we're developing this initiative, we're like, how was it when we were going through puberty, 10 years, 11 years, 12 years, adolescence, trying to figure out what's happening to my body, why am I feeling this type of way, why am I attracted to this kind of people, okay? So we need to listen to them. We need to come to their level and hear what they need and respond effectively rather than create things and chuck them down the
throat.
So that's the lesson, I think.
Amazing. When you talk about sexual behavior, though, in this specific, because you did say this was your second initiative, why this initiative? Like, what is it about this that inspired you that, like, this needs to have something happen to it? Because obviously there's mental health, there's, you know, financial management, there's plenty of other things that could be taught to young people. Why was this so important to you?
I think two reasons. One, sex is exciting. Let's not remove that from the conversation. It ain't cool. It's cool. Look at how the ladies are smiling.
If my grandmother used to say that if God didn't want you to have sex, he wouldn't have made it so fun.
Exactly. Now think about it when you're talking to a teenager. Mm-hmm. How exciting is it?
Yeah.
And the flip side is, there's a crisis on our hands, because if it's not managed right, it's spiraling out of control and leading to so many problems. So we came across very interesting statistics, because we have clients from all over, different categories of brands and all that. And so we came across statistics showing us that, for example, new HIV/AIDS infections amongst the youth are 33%. That's all new HIV/AIDS infections. We came across statistics about teenage pregnancies. Annually in this country, about 400,000. So that's a problem. Yes, sex is fun, but if it's not done responsibly, it opens up Pandora's boxes. Did you know that globally, according to our health research, a million STIs and STDs are documented?
Yeah, they're on the rise, actually.
A million a day. Like, people are sick all over the world.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? That's gross, right? And some people don't even know that you're sick, or don't even know, like, you just think you're itching. But you got some, and there's medication. So we need to
There's a cure, and you don't want to acknowledge it. You just want to be embarrassed.
And, you know, you're too embarrassed to go to the doctor and say, hey, yesterday I did this for this person, and today I burn it.
But sexual behavior, you got to admit, because we've been touching on a lot of topics, is a very broad subject. So when you say sexual behavior, what are you... What is your directive in that statement?
Our directive is we're telling young people that they need to be responsible. Right. Mm-hmm. Or if they're to engage in sexual activities, make sure that first they're aware, mm-hmm. informed of the that every action has a reaction and everything you do has a consequence. Mm-hmm. We're not telling you don't to stop, but be responsible. Mm-hmm. Know that, for example, if you're 13 and you're having sex with your boyfriend, because first and foremost, let's not pretend that they are not having sex, because they are.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So does that mean that if you have sex with your boyfriend today or girlfriend today, that mm-hmm. you have to get pregnant or you have mm-hmm. to make her pregnant?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
You can avoid pregnancy by contraceptives, and you can avoid STIs by mm-hmm. use of condoms, go for testing, things like that.
Yeah.
So it's the responsibility that we're driving. That's what punguza is. So now, tuna punguza, irresponsibility.
Yeah, which I think, first of all, starting the conversation, admitting that teenagers are out here doing it, already some people are like, oh,
I know.
But, you know, it's true, it's happening. When you were a teenager, already answered this question. Our quiz of the hour is, did your parents give you that talk? Mm-hmm. So did you get the birds and the bees talk from your parents?
Well, I come from a single parent family.
Yeah.
So I was brought up by my mom, mm-hmm. and we didn't really have the talk per se,
mm-hmm.
but I knew from her the girls are bad, and I shouldn't hang around girls, because if I do, I won't go to, you know, I won't go to university, and so that was how the talk was packaged to me, and along
nothing
the way I hung around girls, and I'm like, this girls ain't bad. I remember once getting in trouble.
Girls are good.
I once got in trouble with my, I think, headmistress at the time when I was in primary, because of phone calls. So there was a big issue in our school that people are giving out phone numbers, and then we're spending a lot of time calling each other after school. So it became a big
risky.
And this wasn't even about sex, y'all. This is just like, I like this chick, can I call her? Or she likes me, can she call me? And it became a whole problem. Yeah. And for me at that point, I realized, like, I can't talk to my mom about
girls. Yeah, yeah.
Because
it's hard.
She said they're bad.
And I was in trouble. Like, she came to school, man.
She came to school
and she wanted to know, who's this girl?
And who are you? Like, and of course,
and it's so embarrassing.
And of course,
like,
it's harder for a man.
Maybe 11.
11, you were telling
me. I was calling with the landline.
Wow.
Back in the day, it was the
11.
You know, you do.
So you've always been an engaging man since you were young.
I'm just fresh and cute.
It's harder for a man to, like, go to his mother and, like, talk about this. But we have more, like, quizzes, more interesting facts to come up with. But it's officially time for game time.
We're on top. Hey, ladies, ladies, we're on top. Hey.
Okay, game time.
So, we got the famous DIG in the house. And now it is officially time for game time. Mm-hmm. So the game is called True or False. So basically, our guest will be asking us, our host, questions, and we will hold up placards whether it's true or false. So me, Dana, and
thank
Naomi
you.
Will
so
stand.
It's going to be standing position one by one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, one by one.
All together.
Or is it all together? It's going to be all together. So we all stand all together.
Okay. So why is it, you know,
you have the question.
Why
because
is it
you're supposed to
be there.
Not going to be truth or dare.
No?
Not truth or dare.
This is an evening primetime show, young man.
It's for young, the youth.
Okay.
All right.
All right, here we go.
Be nice to us.
Be nice to us, please.
All right. Which is my camera? This one?
That's your camera.
Okay. So question number one, and this is a sex-related question.
Yes,
so brace yourself.
Intercourse-related.
Oh, intercourse-related.
Okay. Yes.
If you have intercourse with a virgin, you'll be clear of the HIV virus. True or false? How do you guys know that answer?
Come on.
You guys really know.
Okay.
Okay.
Question number two. Only men get wet dreams. But that, I didn't know until today that girls get wet dreams.
Okay.
Like,
we all get to mix on ourselves is what's happening.
Okay.
We all get
to
mix on ourselves.
Question number three, is it possible to go blind with pleasure?
Wait, in the moment?
In the moment.
Yeah.
Sure.
She says true.
In the moment.
True.
You know,
you're not blind.
I get blind. Not permanently blind, but
so the answer is actually true.
What?
According to this.
What? According to what?
According to your statistics, what is the answer?
Okay, tell us the facts.
Because you close your eyes and you can't see.
Oh my God. I was right.
Okay. Temporary blindness.
I was right.
Temporary.
You didn't say that though.
And you can't see it. You're just seeing stars and you,
next
you can't
question.
Hear.
If you don't believe it's true, you're doing it wrong.
Next question.
Question number four. Intercourse with your socks on is a turn off.
That's an opinion,
it's
though.
Subjective.
That's
yes.
Yeah, that's subjective. Yes.
So you guys like it with the socks on?
I feel like if I'm cold, being on, you're not the right one.
Exactly.
But you know, if your socks are on, you slide.
Basically.
You have a good grip on the floor.
If it's a cold winter night, I'm not going to mind.
6 p.m., guys.
Okay, next.
Question number five. Bananas are aphrodisiacs.
Not me.
She says true. Please.
Is it true for you?
Please elaborate.
Because, okay, bananas are phallic, but they're not an aphrodisiac.
Potassium, to each their own.
Plus, it depends on what banana we're talking about.
Exactly. Oh. What banana are we talking about?
Subjective.
No, y'all are thinking of the egg.
Go ahead.
Next. You can't get pregnant by having intercourse by standing upright.
Incorrect.
Bruh. I really hope you're teaching these kids.
All right.
It's true. Finally, in a study, around 70% of girls aged between 15 and 19 who have had sex say they wish they had waited.
I feel like that's true.
Why is it true? Let's have your opinion.
I think it's true because even amongst my girlfriends and a lot of people I know, majority of people felt like they more did it because, like, oh my God, everyone else has done it. Like,
peer pressure.
Of social pressure. Yeah. Most of the people who I've talked to personally said that they would have waited.
Same here. It was peer pressure or it was the guy pressuring the girl.
Yeah.
I'm going to have a hot take on it. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say it's because we've taught people to equate sexualization or, like, your sexual abilities with, like, your value. So people think, like, oh, let me have sex because I'm not a valuable girlfriend unless I'm having sex. Yeah, you know, like, they don't think themselves as a legitimate person or relationship without it.
Plus, also, the conjugal rights conversation, like, the guy just, you
he's
know,
like,
just,
it's time.
Yeah, it's, you know, if I'm dating you, you got to give it up to
exactly.
me.
Exactly.
And because men, like it's encouraged in boys to be more sexually active.
Yes.
So because they start doing it first, when you are in a relationship
girls
with someone,
pressure.
They feel like they've got to catch up to the person.
Well, actually, statistically.
So we were good, right?
Statistically, though,
women actually have sex earlier than men. And that's mostly because we're adding in the statistic of, like, women going into, like, forced prostitution and things like that.
Okay, well,
yeah.
Okay. Well, yeah,
but even. But also, if you think about it, women are more likely to have sex with someone who is to have intercourse
older.
With someone who's older.
It's true.
So it's more likely for a woman, unfortunately, to lose it younger.
I feel like we did pretty good.
We're educated.
Yes. I was
people.
Really scared you were going to embarrass us and, like, give us some really scary facts,
right?
And we're all going to be wrong.
No. And can I ask one more question?
Of course.
You said you know everyone wishes they could have waited.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
If you could go back, at what point or would you have finally had sex? Like, how long would you have waited? What age?
I wouldn't have. But I think another reason.
Have waited?
I think another reason that people say they would have waited is because they regret who they did it with. Because for me, I had a very healthy experience with it, and that's why I have a more healthy relationship than I think most people I know with intimacy. So for me, I don't think I'd change a thing.
I think I'll change because I realized when I know now what intimacy means and what it's like to be intimate with somebody who, like, number one, I know what I'm doing. First of all, physically, I know what I'm doing to my body. I know energetically what is happening. That intimacy level, to know what it is now, I know that I didn't feel that way then. So I only know because I've done it better now.
So what age would you say?
I think I would say maybe 20. Yeah, I feel like 20. I was like very a lot more mature sexually to understand exactly what I was doing.
Yeah. But then I definitely agree with you. Like me and I lost my virginity at like 18, 19. Mm-hmm. I was very old. So, but I feel like the intimacy level. I regret what I did with who I did it with, but the intimacy level definitely plays a factor into it. And I would have, if I could go back, I don't know, maybe 25, 28.
Really? I was young, but I don't regret what happened. Yeah. I was young, but I don't regret what happened.
Yeah, I love this initiative, number one, because it's provoking conversation even in adults. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, because maybe I might have a cousin who's a lot younger who can't speak to his parent. to our parents. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So maybe we'll be the people who actually do it. So where are you guys going to be going with this initiative? Is there somewhere where people can meet up or how are you spreading the word?
So first and foremost, we're encouraging people to like our pages. Mm-hmm. We are on all social media platforms, especially the main ones, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, at Punguza KE.
Right.
Like the page, engage with the conversation, and just see what we've been doing and learn and also participate.
Yeah.
We're also working towards doing events. So we have two events on our cards. The first one is taking place this Friday, and we're taking the events to the hoods, man. We're not doing this big things in CBD.
Yes.
No. We're going from hood to hood.
Right.
So our first one is this Friday from 8 a.m. at Gedo Rai, 44. Mm-hmm. So the Chief's Camp.
My old neighbors.
And this is the moment where we're celebrating the International Youth Day and the week. Mm-hmm. So it's a free event. At the Chief's Camp, there's a youth empowerment center. Mm-hmm. It's a collaborative project between us and the Youth to Youth Nairobi Consortium. Mm-hmm. And it's free. Let young guys come. There'll be free health services, free contraceptives. Mm-hmm. There'll be counseling. Mm-hmm. There'll be peer-to-peer education. And also entertainment and fun, yo.
Yeah,
we'll be having performances, MCs, DJs,
dancers. Is there an age limit?
No age limit. Come through.
Good.
You know, even if you're old, come and see what the youth are doing.
Yeah, education does not stop at any age. Yeah. So if you want to know something, absolutely go for it. Thank you so much for being here. Also, how successful he is, he's still on time. He's still committed. Mm-hmm. So let's be this in the entertainment industry.
Yeah.
And we appreciate you guys for always being on time, for always being here. So thank you so much for an amazing show. And we will see you guys tomorrow at 6 p.m. My name is Lydia KM. That's Lydia KM on all social media handles.
My name is Dana DeGrazia. That's Hustle Goddess on Instagram and Twitter.
And my name is Naomi Wamboy, WAMBOE on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter.
And of course, yours truly, Mr. DNG, South Africa's number one hype man, signing out. DNG Kenya. Boom!